a great question. Everyone asks about the timeline after a pregnancy, after delivery. Everybody thinks that there's a fixed time. In fact, there is really no fixed time. The doctors always say 6 weeks. It's because we think in 6 weeks' time, all the tissues after the trauma of childbirth, regardless well, whether there's episiotomy or whether there's cesarean section. However, 6 weeks is an arbitrary figure because we know 6 weeks the tissues will heal quite well. The reality is that you really need to take your own time. Some people it might take 6 weeks, some people might be earlier. So we know from statistics that earlier, by 6 weeks, probably about 78% of couples may resume sexual activities. However, 90% of couples probably will resume sexual activity by 6 months. So 6 weeks or 6 months, take your time. But however, some people might even be earlier because there are some studies in 1970s, our previous generations, our mothers and grandmothers, actually starting sexual activity about 2 to 4 weeks. So the reality is there is no fixed time. Take your own time. It's terrible, isn't it? Women have to consider men's issues. They just given birth. Of course, couples actually encounter a lot of issues together because they gave birth to these beautiful babies and they need to move on in their relationship. The issue is that men always feel very rejected in a relationship when mothers started lactating, looking after the babies. Men always feel rejected. Intimacy will resume and men will make advances. However, in order to make men don't feel rejected, one of the easiest ways is to ease into relationship or intimacy very slowly. So one can start thinking about issues like massage or intimacy with prolonged foreplay. And these are the ways to ease into a relationship. Some people will advocate gentle masturbations or something. However, in a relationship, easing into a intimacy is a key way of making men feel not rejected. So obviously it depends on the time. 6 weeks is what we think the women is going to have the stretch vagina or episiotomy or the stitches all heal. Some women may feel pain because the body actually is responding to different hormones. In a woman, the body has estrogen. The estrogen protects the lining of the vagina and makes intimacy a little bit less painful. However, when the woman is lactating, the lining of the vagina becomes very thin, and therefore having sex with some degree of soreness is really to be expected. Pain shouldn't be the issues. So women who previously had tears, episiotomy, stitches, when they start getting prolonged pain, and then despite multiple attempts, this is still painful, it's time to see a doctor. So in short, a slight amount of soreness is to be expected, but pain is really unexpected and abnormal. Go and see a doctor if you encounter problems like that. Right, obviously, the important thing is feel comfortable about this. Remember, you just given birth. This is a biggest event in your life. There's a baby stretching out of the vagina. There might be tears, there might be stitches and everything. On top of all that, there's a new member of family. And of course, your life has changed. There's lack of sleep, there's lactation, you have sore nipples. In order to help yourself, you need to accept one thing. You need to learn that this is the way to ease back into our intimacy. There is no rush. Nobody is comparing each other with other things. So first of all, be aware of the fact that there is no fixed timeline. Take your own time. The second thing I think will be helpful is expect certain abnormalities. For example, some degree of bleeding is to be expected. Some degree of soreness is to be expected, and also bodily changes, for example, the stretch marks and everything back to normal is to be expected. So the easiest thing to do is knowing yourself. So be more self-aware, and that self-awareness can actually lead you to a slow easing back to intimacy and the relationship start again. So the answer to that question is be knowledgeable, understand your body, and also listen to your body because it takes time to get back to a normal routine. The husband should go and earn more money. All right, okay, of course, that's a joke, right? Of course. There's a lot of things a husband can do. First of all, if the husband actually need to be more supportive with the family, and then therefore looking after the children, looking after the baby will be the key so that the wife can have more rest time. Other things husband can do, perhaps setting up a situation where they have date nights. For example, if you actually take the new baby to be looked after by someone else and take the wife out for an exclusively unhustled, undisturbed night out, those will be the key ingredient to resume sexual activity and intimacy. The husband can also need to listen to the wife, because if by listening to a wife, you understand what feels good, what doesn't feel good, what's painful, what's not, and actually avoid doing things that makes them feel uncomfortable. And the husband definitely should not make comment about stretch marks or anything like that, because those are incredibly insensitive. So husbands, listen to these tips, because that's the way to ease back into a relationship. Otherwise, you have a long, long wait.